In 1955, December 1st, a woman named Rosa Parks became the start of what we know now as the Montgomery bus boycott. All because Rosa Parks did not give up her seat when a white bus driver told her to move, she soon got arrested for her actions.
Rosa Parks got arrested and was charged with a $14 fine for violating city ordinance. Rosa Parks said, "I knew someone had to take the first step, and I made my mind not to move."
Her actions to refuse giving up her seat led fellow black citizens to retaliate. Her arrest triggered the Montgomery bus boycott and helped bring together a civil rights coalition that worked throughout the U.S. for racial justice and basic civil rights.
The Montgomery bus boycott was a political and social protest campaign that started in 1955. It was held in Montgomery, Alabama, and it was meant to oppose racial segregation on its public transportation system, for example, buses.
This movement was not only successful because of the many important leaders, but because of all the citizens that contributed.
Not only were blacks involved in the boycott, but whites were also. Some did feel that there was injustice in the transportation system.
After countless arrests, protests, and bombings, the Montgomery bus boycott came to a close in a matter of 381 days.
You want me to help you record?
Rosa Parks was soon released after her arrest. The bus where all this happened had become a powerful symbol of the boycott.
Things like articles and books were created to reflect what has happened over this year-long battle.
In the long run, Martin Luther King Jr., Rosa Parks, and many others' efforts have paid off. Blacks were allowed to sit with whites happily without any disruptions. Okay.